Welcome, I'm Darren, and I'll be your guide today as I look at the 1993-94 NBA Hoops set. For 1993-94, NBA Hoops found itself at its fifth year anniversary. It started out in 89, and this was the fifth set that it had created. And so they wanted to do something kind of special, but they were also at a crossroads because in the first 2 years, they'd made a similar card design, and then the next 2 years, they used a white border in a very different fashion. And all of the cards were focused on really good images. But we were heading into the mid-90s, and the card industry was changing rapidly, not just in terms of the types of cards and the cost of cards, but also in the market of the customers themselves. You see, way back in the early days of NBA Hoops, just a couple of years before, there was no problem selling cards. You just put them out there, people would buy them. And so being the better card just meant that you had an easier time selling cards, but cards would be sold at just massive quantities due to the fact that there were so many people buying packs. But also there was an enthusiasm about buying lots and lots of cards. Over the next couple of years, more high-end cards came in, and that took a bigger chunk out of people's paychecks. There were also more options, so there were too many card sets to buy, and the number of people buying cards, that was dwindling. Now, the collectors were getting a little bit older, which meant that they tended to have more money to spend, but when you have higher-end cards, and you have lots of higher-end cards, that money starts shrinking up very quickly for a base brand like NBA Hoops, and that was the problem that NBA Hoops suffered from, was the fact that it was a base brand that was competing now with Topps and with Fleer, and both of those card companies had developed a really good gimmick. In the case of Topps, they had a parallel, and that was all they had going for it, but my word, that was all that they needed. And then over with Fleer, they had lots of inserts. Not necessarily inserts that came up in packs a lot, but they had inserts for people to chase, and that means that both of those cards, the packs for those cards flew off shelves at a very quick rate, whereas with NBA Hoops, they didn't really have very much, so collectors weren't as drawn to buying the packs. So for 1993, here we were at a celebration of 5 years, and Hoops had to very quickly catch up. So they decided to go ahead and do both inserts and a parallel. I'll obviously get both of those, but let's start off with the core development, which was, what did they do about their card design? So for the first 2 years, like I said, they had a very similar card design. The next 2 years likewise had a different, but similar between them, card design. Well, here they wanted to continue to focus on images because that's really what NBA Hoops was riding on. But they decided, why not just get rid of the border? Do something like Stadium Club. So with a completely borderless, full-bleed design, the image had a lot more strength, the ability to really pop right off of the card. And then down at the bottom, they had just a little band that wasn't even a full band with the team logo, some strong team colors. And this card really did work at celebrating the player. That was what they were going for, and that's what they pulled off doing. Even on the card back, they really cleaned it up quite a bit. Here, they did a vertical format, which allowed them to put in some... They were able to continue to use the college stats, which is a really cool feature that Hoops like to have on its cards. A little bit of floorboards up at the top to give kind of a hint of a theme. All of the things they needed to do on the card back, they were able to do, but they were able to do it in a more professional way. And this was a great development. So the card was really growing up. And on top of that, like I said, they did want to do a parallel, but it was also the fifth year anniversary, so why not merge the two together? So the parallel is their fifth anniversary gold cards. They have a gold medallion that's up on the card, and this is embossed, which means actually on the back there's a slight relief to it. So the cards have a unique tactility to them that were really cool. And then down at the bottom, they also have a gold strip on either side, which gives it makes the whole card feel really elegant. This is a really impressive performance. They really pulled it off and really, really showed Topps, you know, if you try, you can make a good card. So they basically took what Topps was doing in 1992 and just made a way, way better version of it. That's pretty much what this card is. And it worked really well. Whole set is done with them. Now, in NBA Hoops fashion, they had the players, and then they had the team coaches. So all the coaches show up, you know, likewise, same design with the parallel. And then they followed that up with the All-Star teams, the Eastern and the Western teams. In this case, because everything's so simplified, there's not really much of a difference between the East and the West. The cards are, you know, it's more the jersey that really reads between them in this case. But yeah, nice cards. And they also had team cards for both the East as well as for the West. Then they had their league leaders. And the league leaders are an opportunity to pause, because this was not the first year they were doing league leaders, but it sure feels like it, because these cards look really cool. Because of the simplicity of the design, this gives you a really good three-panel image with really strong, the strength of the image of each player comes through. This is reminiscent of the early 80s Topps card that was the three panels, which Upper Deck would kind of bring back at some point. But this card, this is the card that makes me really wonder why they didn't do this more often, because these cards look really cool. They are not a three-panel card. They're a single panel with three images, but they do have that feel, because NBA Hoops was doing a really good job selecting images and making them work on the card. This was a card that they worked really hard to get done right, and you know, it's their fifth year anniversary, so you would expect for them to do that. And here they were really coming through. And then they have a David Robinson Boys and Girls Club card. David Robinson was their spokesman for the year, and so he was featured on the boxes. And so there was a strong David Robinson quality to this card set. They were already kind of attached to David Robinson, but 93 was very much a big leaning into it. And then, of course, they had their NBA Finals cards, which they love to do. They'd been doing this for a couple of years. Again, these cards really do come through beautifully on these in these subsets. And then they close out the set, their Series 1 set, with three checklists, which all have different shots of David Robinson. So that if you're a David Robinson collector, there are actually multiple checklists to collect. And then you have Series 2, and actually Series 2 is, you know, they have some rookies, but it's basically just player cards, no subsets, which is very unusual for NBA Hoops, and then a couple of checklists at the end, again, some more David Robinson checklists, and then the set comes to a close. So, interestingly, they were simplifying the card set from what it had been in the past, which I don't know why they bothered to do that. I personally like subsets. I grew up on them, but at any rate, they were streamlining and trying to get really focused on just making a really good card set. Now, they did have two SP cards, and the first SP card is Magic Johnson, Larry Bird card. So these two players had just retired, and so they wanted to pay tribute to that with this this single panel card with the two images. And the cards, interestingly, these cards also come with a parallel. So you have the base SP card, and then you have the parallel of it. So they come in both ways. And then they also did a special David Robinson fifth year anniversary card, where on the front, it has a take on his rookie card. And, well, not really a take, it's almost like a reprint with some additional gold foil. And then on the card back, they show the other David Robinson cards. So that was the other SP card. They also had autographs in both cases. So the Larry Bird Magic Johnson card, it has an autographed version. And the David Robinson card, it has an autographed version. And those came from vouchers. So that was, they were still doing a couple of SP cards, but that was kind of fading off into the background. They did lean heavily into inserts, however. And Admiral's Choice is the first insert set that they did. And Admiral's Choice is basically kind of an all young player team. That's kind of the way that it was approached. So these are young players that David Robinson is really looking forward to watching their career progress. And then they also had a David's Best set. And this was looking at different amazing games that David Robinson, or different notable games that David Robinson had. Has some holofoil on the front, which is, it's an overly understated card, but it is a subset that they did, which, you know, again, you can see they're really leaning in on David Robinson. And then they also had a voucher in Series 1 for, it was a redemption card for a draft lottery set. This was something that was just starting to happen, and it would have a pretty strong history down the road with not just hoops, but across a couple of different card brands. And the idea was that we were all excited about the upcoming rookies, but for an early set, those tended to come out sometimes before you even knew who the players who were drafted even were. So card companies would start to put in these lottery picks. The redemption cards for lottery picks would be redeemable for whoever was drafted. In this case, it was for the whole set. So you send in this one card and you get a complete set of really, really nice, elegant shots of the players on draft day. It looks more like a skybox card. It's got some nice gold foil on it. Just, these read really well. So this was a cool set that they had with the set. And then they also have face-to-face, and this is a matchup of kind of like rivalries, not entirely rivalries, but a good matchup of two different players. These cards have a chrome finish over the background. So the player himself is just a normal glossy shot. The background has kind of a lighting effect. Sorry that it can't come out very well in these shots. It's really tough to get these cards just right and, you know, the way that I do it. So, but this does exist. And then they also have a Magic's All-Rookie Team, which is looking forward to the All-Rookie Team for this draft. These are the guys that you're really excited about. But in this case, it's actually built like an All-Rookie Team. So, and then they have their NBA Scoops, or NBA Hoop Scoops. And the Scoops set is one team card for every single team. It's a straightforward picture on the front with a strip of black down at the bottom, team logo. Nothing else really too cumbersome. But on the card back, these cards all have five questions. Every single team has five questions. And all of these cards in the set do also come with a gold parallel. So just like the Bird Magic card, these also do have the parallel. And the last card in the set is an answer card. So it gives you the key to the questions of all of these teams. And then the last set they did was Supreme Court. They'd been doing this for a while, but by 1993, they had already turned it into an insert set. And these are really, really nice cards. I love the way that the wood grain looks, the way the whole card comes together. It's got to be the most professional of all the inserts of this card set. But that's kind of the theme for 1993. Hoops was trying to grow up. It was trying to seem like an affordable premium brand. That was really what they were going for. And they were doing a good job here with this 1993 set of really, really cementing that idea. And then there were two other items to talk about, two and a half. So while they did have one panel of cards that was like a promo, they also did team cards or team night sheets. They did a few of those here in 1993. So they also had those, but they also had a special bread release of cards. I'm sorry, right now as I'm recording this, the company that did the bread, it's not hitting me, so I apologize for not specifying that, but the cards they're all unnumbered. They're the same, the cards in the set are the same as the regular cards in the set, except they don't have card numbers on them. That's the only difference. And it doesn't even advertise in any other way. Now, it could be kind of like the team sheet cards, except the team sheet cards have perforation on them. In this case, these don't have perforations. They're normal cards, but they have no numbers. So that's how those cards come across. Other than that, that's what they did for 1993-94. Now, for 1994-95, they would take this idea and they would evolve it a little bit. I'm going to look at that in a separate video. I'm going to explore that card set all on its own, which is very much what I'm going to need to do. But for 1993-94, I think this works well for this video. So if you have any questions about it, you know, definitely ask questions down in the comment section below. Subscribe if you haven't done so already. Check out my other videos, and thank you very much for watching.